Hello viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel Physics with Hrishikesh. Today we are going to start a new series, that is optics. Today we will discuss about the reflection of light. And watch the video till the end. At the end of this video, I will provide one small trick which will help you to solve many mathematical problems. So let's start. Reflection of light. First of all, we have to know the definition of reflection. Suppose a beam of light traveling in a medium be incident on the surface of the separation between two media. Suppose this is my media 1, this is my first media, and this is my second medium, and the ray of light is incident on the surface of separation of the two media. Then if a portion of the incident light is turned back to the first medium, then this phenomenon of light is called the reflection of light. This is my incident ray of light and this is my reflected ray of light. This is normal to the plane of separation between two media and this is the incident ray. So this angle I is called the incidence angle and this angle is called angle of reflection. Now we have to know some phenomena of reflection by plane mirror. For a plane mirror, its focal length is f equal to infinity and its power is p equal to 0. This is for the case of plane mirror. Now, the image formed by the plane mirror is always virtual and erect, and the object distance will be equal to the image distance. Object distance will be equal to the image distance. So the linear magnification will be given by m equal to image by object, that is v by u, equal to 1, since object distance v and image distance u are equal and the image is laterally inverted. Laterally inverted. And firstly, I told you the image will be virtual and erect. The nature of the image will be virtual and erect. Now, laterally inversion is, suppose this is a mirror, the object is the letter W, then its image will be like this. So from here you cannot understand the lateral inversion. But if we write P is the object, then the image will be like this. From here you can understand the lateral inversion. Next topic is the deviation of a ray of light due to reflection at plane mirror. Suppose this M prime is my plane mirror. A ray of light is incident by following this path and it is reflecting by following the path OB. N is the normal to this point, and we know for plane mirror the angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. In that case, these two angles are I. Now the deviation of the light will be this angle. This is the deviation of the light. The path of the incident ray of light is extended by following this path, and this is the deviation of the light. Now, what will be the angle of deviation? The angle of deviation is given by D equal to, this angle is B O, suppose this is Q, that is B equal D equal to B O Q. therefore it is written as D equal to BOQ. Now we can write this as angle AOQ minus angle AOB. Angle AOQ minus angle AOB. Now the angle AOQ is 180 degree and angle AOB is I plus I, that is 2y. So the deviation will be 180 degree minus 2y. Number of images formed by the plane mirrors. Suppose two mirrors are inclined to each other with their reflecting surfaces facing each other and an object is placed in between them, then the number of images will be formed is given by, if this angle is theta, that is theta is the angle between the mirrors, then the number of images will be given by n equal to 360 degree by theta minus 1. This formula holds if 360 degree by theta is even integer. If 360 degree by theta is even integer and n equal to 360 degree by theta, then equal to odd integer, then two cases are possible. First case, this is the two plane mirrors. If the object is placed just in between them, that is this angle and this angle are same, that is the object is placed symmetrically, in that case n will be equal to 360 degree by theta minus 1. And if the object is placed asymmetrically, that is this is the point of the object, that is this is the position of the object O, and these two angles are not equal, then n will be equal to 360 degree by theta. This is all about plane mirrors. Now move on to the spherical mirrors. We know two types of spherical mirrors are possible. One type is concave mirror and the other type is convex mirror. Now for concave mirror, the mirror equation is given by, we all know this, 1 by v plus 1 by u equal to 1 by f, where u is the object distance, v is the image distance and f is the focal length of the mirror. Now from this we can write 1 by v equal to 1 by f minus 1 by u. But for concave mirror, f equal to negative, f is always negative, and for real object u is always negative. That is, for concave mirror f is always negative, for real object u is always negative. In that case 1 by v equal to minus 1 by f plus 1 by u, LCM uf, that is u minus f. Now f, v equal to given by uf divided by u minus f. If in any case u is less than f, then v will be negative. Now for convex mirror, similarly the mirror formula is given by 1 by v plus 1 by u equal to 1 by f, or we can write 1 by v equal to 1 by f minus 1 by u. Now for convex mirror, f is always positive. You have to memorize this sign convention, that is for concave mirror f is negative and for convex mirror f is positive, and for real object u is negative as before. As f is always positive and for real object u is negative, that is v is always positive, so we always get a virtual image of the object. For convex mirror. Now, Newton's equation. We all know the equation of the mirror, 1 by V plus 1 by U equal to 1 by F, and we know that F equal to R by 2. So this will be 2 by R. Now take the LCM, UV, U plus V equal to 1 by F, or we can write UV equal to UF plus VF, or UV minus UF plus VF equal to 0. Now add both sides, F square, and take common U V minus F plus minus F into V minus F. This will give F square, or we can write U minus F into V minus F equal to F square. Suppose X and Y be the object and image distances from the focus. Suppose this is my spherical mirror. This is its focus. Object distance is U and image distance is either V or V, whatever. Just understand the concept. The object distance is now measured from the focus. It is X and it is Y, or this is Y, not from the pole. In that case, we can write U minus F equal to X, because U is the total distance of the object from the pole and V is the distance of the image from the pole. Now, if we consider the object distance from the focus, in that case U minus F will be X and V minus F will be Y, that is F square. So the Newton's equation is given by XY equal to F square. Velocity of image in mirror. Suppose for a spherical mirror, an object is moving with some velocity, then its image will move with some velocity. Now we know the mirror formula, 1 by V plus 1 by U equal to 1 by F. Now differentiating both sides with respect to time, we get minus 1 by V square dv dt minus 1 by U square du dt. Look, the focal length for a particular mirror is fixed. So if we take derivative with respect to time, then it will provide 0. So we can write from here dv dt equal to minus v square by u square du dt, where dv dt is the velocity of the image, du dt is the velocity of the object, u is the object distance and v is the image distance. So if I know the object distance and image distance and the velocity of the object, then by using this formula we can evaluate the velocity of the image. The last and most important part of this chapter. Let us see, if we put an object in a particular position, what will be its image formed and the nature and size of the image. Now we'll discuss first about the concave mirror. Suppose this is the pole of my mirror, this is the focal point, and this is twice F. If we put the object at infinity, the image will be formed at the focus of the mirror and the nature will be real, inverted and very small. If we put the object at any point between twice F and infinity, then the image will be formed in between F and twice F, and the nature will be real, inverted and small. Now if we put the object at twice F, then the image will also formed at V equal to twice F, and the size of the image will be equal to the size of the object, and nature will be real and inverted. Next case, if we put the object in between F and twice F, the image will be formed in between twice F and infinity, and the nature and size will be real, inverted and large. Now, if we put the object at F, the image will be formed at infinity, and the image will be real, inverted and very large. Last, if we put the object at a point between pole and first focal point F, then the image will be formed behind the mirror and it will be large. Now, for convex mirror, if we put the object at infinity, the image will be formed at F focal length and its nature will be virtual, erect and very small. As we know, for convex mirror, always the image will be virtual and erect. Okay, now I will provide you a small trick. If the object distance is n times its focal length for a mirror, then the magnification will be m equal to 1 divided by n plus 1. Suppose there is a question that the object is placed in front of a mirror at a distance twice the focal length of the mirror, then what will be the magnification? In that case, u equal to twice f, here the value of n is 2, so the magnification will be 1 by 2 plus 1, that is 1 by 3. So this is the trick of this video. In the next class, we will solve different previous year's mathematical problems in details. So thank you for watching this video. If you like, please hit the like button, share with your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you.